Hello and welcome to Advertisers Watching Ads. My name is Tom Ollerton. I'm the founder of Automated Creative. And this is a weekly show where brands watch other brands' ads and discuss what's good and bad about them. We're brought to you as ever by Contagious.com. So please go and check those guys out after the show who have helped choose this week's ad. So before we see this week's ad, let's meet this week's guests.
Hi, I'm Tim Hull and I am an innovation coach at Sky UK.
Hi, my name is Leanne Johnston and I'm the CEO and founder of Affiliate Insider.
Hi, I'm Cicero. I'm head of the digital hub in Western Europe for Reckitt.
What a diverse panel. This is going to be very interesting. And what an ad. Let's have a look at it.
17 degree approach is fine.
Now extend the landing gear.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Tim, what do you think about the first
one? What is not to love? You know, for anyone that's been to Rocky Horror Picture Show, Sing Along Frozen that I went to with my daughter when she was six, all this immersive stuff, like it's so much fun. And with the things that are going on at the moment with the metaverse, things like that, it's clear that there's a playground here for the two-dimensional to become something that we can reach out and touch and smell and see other sounds with. I'm envious. I wanted to be one of those people on the plane.
How about you, Liam? Were you swept up in the creativity of it all?
Well, as an acquisition marketer, I mean, it's every marketer's dream, right? 150 influencers, no fees, and 3 million people watched your content. I mean, what's not to love about it? The genius behind it is it's simple, but it's so effective. And it really does highlight the fact that micro content curators can have a huge, massive reach. And thinking about how you work with these people to, you know, push brand, push messaging, push product is really something that every digital marketer needs to be thinking about right now.
Cicero, are you equally swept up in the joyous influencingness of this?
I am. And what a feat to pull the whole thing off, Ryan. It's all live, people participating. Bit of a Hunger Games vibes on, you know, people actually also watching it at the same time. You know, even foster an audience as you, you know, broadcast the event and people participate. It's all in one type of event. I was very surprised that I didn't hear about it. I was like watching it like, why wasn't I invited?
So I'm in the uncomfortable position of having to try to find the counterpoint here. And there's a few, right? So first off, no fees. How did that work?
Well, I think essentially there were fees. I mean, there was a production fee and there were streaming fees and there were obviously costs associated to this campaign. But I think what they were talking about is that they didn't have to pay the influencers to create this unique content. We do want to think about how do we leverage content, and everybody keeps telling us content is king. This really shows how you need to be using free content in order to generate that reach. That to me is the most powerful thing that happened in this campaign.
I think it was a bit of a humble brag on the fees thing side of things, right? It's like, what an achievement, and probably catered to the marketeers that would watch that rather than the whole action behind it. But I think it's also super interesting how they've been able to do it with Twitch, you know, which is a place that, you know, only the really big brands are playing in. And then you come with this very B movie and you do the whole, you know, live show decision making in there. It becomes, you know, multiple things at once that also acquires the admiration, I think, of people to see, wow, these guys went to the real lengths to really do this and, you know, prove that they've got a great product behind it.
They've got those influencers there somehow. Someone's contact book got paid for and they managed to say the right thing to those influencers. I want to see what the messaging looked like that got those influencers there that didn't involve them being paid. How did they tie into those influencers' passion points and said, we're going to give you an experience that you're not going to get anywhere else. You need to come along to this aircraft hangar middle of nowhere and watch a movie. Or what did they say?
It's FOMO and it was curiosity. Two key things that build every human into a follower or a watcher or a lurker, whatever you want to call us. Again, it comes down to not just what you post, but how you're posting it and why you're posting it. And that's the real key thing, is what was the objective of the campaign? And that was reach. Reach is what they attained.
We have to applaud the people who got ready for that event too, because hundreds of meetings would have taken place. Lots of budgets would have flown around. This looks like it's still kind of a unique thing. And therefore this cost a lot of money, involved a lot of people. You know, when we look at the actual messaging too here, I wasn't sure whether this piece was advertising the experience company that put it on, or was it advertising the movie? Like, there isn't release dates on there for territories or anything like that. I end it going, I'm kind of interested in the movie. I'm really interested in the experience. What was I being sold there? What's my action point at the end? Do I click a link, buy a ticket, go somewhere? What was the activation?
Using concepts like this, marketing concepts like this, I think is very, very important for merging the online and offline experience together, which a few brands get right. Recently, so I think H&M has a shop in the metaverse that they've now created. Zara is doing, you know, trying on, and everybody's exploring and touching this kind of area of digital, but nobody's really getting it right. And I think this did as a starting point.
Do you think we're going to see these kind of physical things die out as incredible VR, AR experiences are rolled out instead at scale?
I think the concept of, you know, a parallel track, right, a metaverse already kind of happens with live events. And this is kind of how people want also to interact with these live events. They want to have a little bit of a way to, you know, push forward or participate or influence the outcome. And I think that's also part of where we will see more experimentation. How can people who are not there physically influence the outcomes and feel like they belong and they've done something or they voted in?
My son loves Bear Grylls. And you can choose on Netflix whether he goes up the mountain or down the drain or whatever it is. And I mean, it just, it's that, it's talking to that next generation of consumer, because, you know, he's 9 years old and he watches the internet. He watches other people playing on YouTube. We don't let him on Twitch or anything like that. Like, everything's curated that he watches, but it's just, it's understanding who's your customer, who's your audience, and what do they want? You know, they don't necessarily want to go to a website and read a content article and then click a link and purchase something. So how are you using all of these free social media channels to actually leverage your content and push it out there to people, to your actual end audience?
It's telling you how to respond as well. It's telling you you're going to be shocked. You're going to scream. You're going to be disrupted. It's telling you what that emotional experience is going to be like. This really seems to really carefully take you in and say that you're going to have the most amazing time, even if when you see the film, you're a bit like, oh, you know, yeah, action movie, interesting story. Yeah, a few vampires, it's all right, you know, but they've taken you to that high pitch of this is what it's going to be like, even if maybe you don't experience that when you go yourself.
Well, unfortunately, guys, we're at the end of the show. So what I'm going to ask you to do is vote for how good you thought this was. So 3, 2, 1. A 4 and a 5 and a 5. That's incredibly high scoring. Well done, Netflix. Brilliant bit of work. Guys, thank you so much for your time. We'll see you all next week.